Hell yeah. I have many new mods, and for upcoming Zeus mission for the Arma gorillas, I'm trying to come up with the heavy assault trooper loadout. And, well, I'm pretty sure one of the new mods has changed the parameters of this weapon. It used to be able to fire like 2600 bullets out of 200 bullet boxes before overheating. But now it's about as shitty as all of the other ones of its kind. So that real fucking sucks. There's a this pretty nice new mod, Octocamo. Well, if you've played Metal Gear Solid games, such as the third one for PS3, you know he has a suit which changes its appearance depending on the surroundings. Well, in Arma 3 it can't be as good. It can only react to the ground. If you are in buildings, it doesn't react to the floors, only the underlying ground. So if I... What was the button? Yeah, there. The mod page said you have to do the salute to reset the... Right, it ain't anywhere here. Whatever. Well, the problems, if you can call them that, is that the Octocamo suit, it doesn't have as good... Actually, yeah, let's see. Explosive resistance, it's up to the B over there. Special purpose. It does have lower ballistic and explosive resistances, but it kicks the special purpose suit's ass in the load department, which is why which is my pretty much only problem with the special purpose suit. Yeah. Also, 3.63 kilos. Since the special purpose suit has more protection, it has higher weight. So yeah, that makes sense. So, yeah, the Octocamo suit is like a strict stealth suit or something like that. They've even made female variants. It's just a thinner model, well, for pretty obvious reasons. And since the sort by load has been fixed in Ace Arsenal, that now makes my life fucking way fucking easier. And these ones, these are actually, they don't work like that. Well, at least when I tested, like, it says here, no armor, but that armor value in that tooltip, it's completely separated. It's the, I think it was vanilla, and it's simply not added, but let's go back here. As you can see, ballistic protection extremely high. Well, the load statistic, it's true, it works as intended, but the ballistic protection, it's horseshit. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So 18 shots. Well, that's pretty damn good. Last time I tried, it was 10 shots. Around this distance or something. But if you are much closer, like this CQC distance, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Never mind 12, since I somehow hit the gun. 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, so even now it worked. As far as I know, they haven't updated the mod. So I have no idea why it worked that way. In my opinion, these vests aren't that nice looking. Besides, they only have this one color scheme. Personally, I like this VSM Project Honor. Personally, I like this one. LBT 6094 Gunner. Compared to, well, yeah, literally every other vest currently my mods allow, this is the most balanced, and it even has a very reasonable weight. As for backpacks, US SAC backpack, it's easily the best out of all of these. It's very lightweight. yeah, it's sort by load. And yeah, these two are very small, but then it's a big one. But the weight and load is the same. But yeah, then the next step are the bergens. This kind of jump with this kind of weight jump, that ain't good by any stretch. So and yeah, for example, yeah, here the trick carry all. Actually, all of the vanilla carry alls, same weight, same load. Well, the Alice for RHS, and then VSM Project Hunter carryall, same deal, no difference apart from the looks. And then comes the Viper harness, where it's the Woodland Hex is by Avery the Kitty, but the rest are. Yeah, there are a couple of variants of the Viper harness by Avery the Kitty. The rest are vanilla or through a DLC. Instead of the Viper harness, the USMC Molle packs. They are good in the sense that the weight is acceptable, the load is pretty good. So, for example, if we jump from the Molle to back to the US SOC backpack, we lose half the weight but gain a little more load. So, I think it's pretty damn obvious. Nothing else competes. Yeah, and look at this shit. Alice pack this load, 227, and we jump to check paratrooper backpacks. The bag is heavier, but no load chains. That's simply stupid. Oh yeah, and the bullshit doesn't end here. My personal favorite has been these trick tactical backpacks until I got them. Wait a minute. USMC. Oh yeah, Massi. Until I got the mod by Massi, my personal favorite was easily the trick tactical backpacks. Real lightweight and very generous load. So let's again jump back to here for the load. Well, it ain't a massive jump, but considering the weight also ain't that much bigger, 0.2 something, I can't calculate that in my head. Jumping from the trick tactical backpack to US backpack by Massi. No brainer. It's fucking obvious. There's simply no substitute. In fact, things like the C-door, they weighed around the same as this, but they got like half of the load. Let's check. Oh yeah, get back. Another stupidity. Also, very... The German mod, it also brings some kitbacks, but yeah, most of the kit, some of the kitbacks were vanilla or through a mod, DLC, not mod. But yeah, this field pack to be that medic. Wait, what? Yeah, this is extremely common right now with the mods, that it's this load and this weight. Well, the Viper light harness, it's a pretty good one. Let's compare it to the Viper harness. Well, the load jump, not that much, but the weight jump, holy fuck. Which is why, while I was still learning the game, the backpack IDF and Spetsnaz bag, they were my favorites for to be as the general purpose backpacks. But then, well, actually, yeah, either of these over the UMBTS backpacks, because these weigh more, but they lose a little load. So that's stupid. Oh yeah, and yeah, pretty much every backpack from here down the chain, they don't got jack shit on these or these. They simply weigh way too fucking much. Sure, they're... Let's ignore those weapon and such. But there are some of these zero weight bags. Well, just a belt. And then, yeah, Jabs. Attack mod or something. Was where these and many others came from. And then we jump here. So yeah. Yeah, this color makes it obvious. It's a... back belt and also a pistol holster. So I think it's pretty damn obvious which one is the one to go of these. But then shit gets better. It's the same belt but with more slots. Well, I think there's there has to be some kind of def error here. I'm not even sure how these should differ. Seems like an accidental duplication. But these butt packs, these are fun. I mean, you got this small bag which carries more than anything of these. That's fun. But oh boy, well, my understanding is these gun bags are in Arma 3 are meant to be used to swap out weapons easily, not in the same way as you track drop weapon from the bag to your slot and stuff. These are also pretty fun. Well, these radio packs, they don't count for this. And again, we come to the butt packs. Well, these variants were where you got these side pouches. These should store more stuff, but according to the load, they don't. I haven't tested, but most likely it's true. But now we come to ones which do have weight. Wait, what? I suppose Jab made these variants, which I guess are identical, but they do have weight. I guess it's for realism's sakes. But these truck range master belts, these are stupid compared to anything before it. But now that the butt packs come with a holster, the carry weight increases a little. But then there are these bags. Here are the sidors. These are all identical. I have no fucking clue. Wait, what? Yeah, one is pure RHS, two LOP. No, that ain't Lobes of War. And then we got these messenger bags. They carry a little more than the Sidors, yet they weigh exactly the same. The RPG carrier, well, it's only good for role-playing purposes. Oh yeah, but then Zabs, Tac MTAPs. Since these have a decent load, but zero weight, they would be my favorite. And then we come to US Assault Packs from CUP. I don't need to explain why these are stupid idea by comparison. But then these VSM compact bags. When we installed the VSM mod, I don't know what it's actually called. I only know it says VSM here. When we installed the mod so we could play KP Liberation in some kind of Middle Eastern or something map, I used these compact bags for these reasons. And of course, there are assault bags, most of which are vanilla. They are equally good. Back when I started with Arma 3, we did use these Falcon 2 bags. Well, this ain't so bad. I tested. I'm not on the Patreon at all. Yet these worked just fine. So I guess they are like gifts from Avery the Kitty for the generosity of the patrons. That's why it's available. Well, that's my impression, at least. Oh yeah, the RPG pack. It's worthless. Let's compare that to the RPG carrier. Yeah, the weight doubles, but the load. Nope. It's like 20% increase, so that's stupid. Oh yeah, the US Assault Pack carry, that was later my favorite backpack. Reasonable weight and decent load. But yeah, now we jump to Falcon 2s. Stupid. Yeah, the field packs were our primary bag when we started playing. Actually, it was for a long time when we played Antistasi, well, we still do, but yeah, but we have the UM BTS backpacks. Succeed in them. And now it goes stupid. This ain't realistic nor good in any sense. So I have no fucking idea why Zab made this with that weight. Yeah, this is also stupid. I never used this backpack for this very reason, because I knew there were better ones. Trees. These. TAC MTAP butt packs. They are very good. But like I here said, the USMC, US SOC backpacks. They are the king right now. I probably should show why they are so good. Let's drop these belts. As you can see, the 117, it takes, I guess that's 40% of the weight. Well, obviously I can't fit that there, but now I can. And I can even take these 200 bullet belts. Yeah, I can take two of them besides the fully equipped gun. So that's pretty damn good. Let's quickly add my generalized fighter medic loadout to the backpack. So, was it control? No. Shift? Control shift? No. Okay, I'll just hold shift. Okay. The bandages. Twenty epis. I think it was 25 morphines, and I'm not sure. But it doesn't change stuff much. Well, I typically take 12 1000 salines, but let's take 15. Nowadays we have to use surgical kit or the pack, because the wounds can reopen, but a pack has strict requirements. You have to, the target has to be awake, not bleeding, only some blood. The pain level is ignored. It's completely fixed regardless of what it is. And of course, 8. Sometimes I take 12 tourniquets. Yeah, that's it. Although, I've been dropping a few some epis and adding a few morphines. Because I realized that even if I use the epis far more to possibly, I don't know how well it works since I haven't checked the source code. But allegedly, you can use epis to increase the chances of restarting the heart. I do use them for that sometimes, but not like all the time. So more like 15 epis tends to be enough, and add 3 morphines. But yeah, the since the epis and morphines weigh the same, so we can emulate it now. 1, 2, 3. So I weigh now 4478. That's because of this heavy loadout. This gun itself is 10 kilos, a little over. 3429. Of course, yeah, ignore what's here and here for this. Now, if I drop this back, 3429, 2146. That's four nine. That's 13 kilos. A little under 13 kilos. This bag plus my generally balanced fighter medic loadout. Well, obviously I can't take 117 in there, but for that purpose I can move shit around. These extras. Yeah, let's drop that. Okay. Actually, let's keep that. Let's take that. And let's move some of this away. Oh yeah, the server no longer allows to use to non-medics to use epis, so I'll always move these out of the backpack if I can. No, fuck you. I can't fit it yet. As you can probably see, this vest can store fuck lots of stuff. You can't store anything like this with any other vest. Believe me, I know. I've tried. Now I can fit it. Let's move some of this back. Okay, now it's packed full. Well, nearly, most likely. Well, actually, I don't know if only medics can use the surgical kit. But yeah, that probably can be moved. So yeah. Now, this bag, it contains, yeah, the vast majority of my medical. And it also carries the 117. This is a lot of stuff. That's why the US backpack is so damn good. For the mission, and generally, I've started to carry 1+1 boxes of ammo for an LMG or the like, because I can simply use green mag to refill both boxes once I'm out. But let's switch to the full mag and see how far we can get with full auto firing of this thing. Weapon temp, yeah, it's 0. Remember, this is 200 bullets per box. And this is the most lightweight box in terms of bullets per weight. Okay, yeah, the mag is empty. Check weapon up. Yeah, it's fucking halfway overheating already. So this fucking thing can fire maybe 2 mags before it starts to lock up. Let's put in the non-full. And fire it away. Okay, it's empty. Yeah, it's almost overheating. So let's remove those and get a new one. Yeah, I got the universal ammo system mod installed for testing, but it's mostly pointless. 100% pointless. All these boxes weigh the exactly same, but it's my personal preference. I prefer these pouches. They look better. And I prefer the yellow tracers. They show up better during the day. And also during the night. Wait, is it? Yeah. Well, it actually managed to cool down quite a bit. It's jammed. The jamming is random, so even when your weapon hasn't even heated up, it can still lock up. There's nothing that can be done about that. Okay, it's again jammed. Now, it's completely overheated. Let's try to clear it. Cleared. Okay, now it's empty. Yeah. So, as it stands, you can fire 600 bullets with this thing. Well, almost 600 bullets. That's 3 times 200. That ain't good in any sense, but it's still much better than with the M4 type assault rifles. You can fire 100 or 150 bullets with them before it's completely overheated. So, yeah. Besides, as I said, these boxes store more ammo at a lower weight than the assault rifles. Which is why I concluded that these heavy assault troopers, they must be using an LMG if they are USA or NATO. There's simply no substitute. My bad, yeah. The gun itself is fairly lightweight, 6.64. But all the additional shit I've put on it, that's why it weighs so much. A long ass silencer, a grip with the bipod, and a dual mode laser and light, and of course a dual mode thermal scope. This thing is badass. Sure, the loadout gets pretty damn heavy, especially for a medic. Yeah, take a look at this. Okay, we are close. Yeah, here. 200 bullets, 181. And then there are these universal ammo system mags. Well, some of these sound very nice. Like this armor piercing. I suppose that since they are armor piercing, it makes sense they are heavier. But I tried using these double drums, and not from the UAS, but from the game itself. As you can see, it fucking blocks the fucking screen. And when you ADS, it blocks a very big part of it. So that ain't good. Even I know that ain't good. But shit gets worse. Here are other of these boxes, but these are either no tracer or mixed tracers, meaning there are no tracers and tracers in the same box. I think it's every fourth or fifth is a tracer. These don't have any weight differences among themselves. I don't know what the difference between A1 and non-A1 is, because there's no change here. But yeah, same bullet count, but the weight is still bigger. Oh yeah, and these 150 drums, even worse. This is the same one, with 50 fewer bullets. It's stupid. I simply can't accept using this. Oh yeah. And these boxes, they are invisible. In fact, didn't that cause? Okay, so it works, but okay, let. Huh? That reload. I can already fire while the reload is still going on. So, yeah, no. No deal. But here's where shit gets absolutely stupid. I tested this huge boxes earlier. You will carry more ammo with those 200 bullet boxes I showed, the 181s, than you would with one of these 2000 boxes. Just look at this shit. 6765 4497. And the reload. These fucking boxes weigh over 20 kilos. Yet, when you take 200 bullet boxes, you will save. It was several kilos. So this is, to put it honestly, stupid. There's simply no point in this UAS max. Well, most of them anyway. Also, yeah, these Bohemias Max, they don't work with these guns. So, I did plenty of tests. This helmet, it's a Soviet / Russian origin, but it actually works. It has a high ballistic and explosive resistance. It's from a mod. I don't even know what mod. One of those tech mods, pretty sure. When I tested, you can take an AK shot to the head with this helmet, and you will go unconscious, but your heart won't stop. Plus, it's pretty lightweight by comparison. Like, take a look at this. We have a Matsuril helmet AOR2. It weighs double, but it doesn't protect the face. I tested. It does protect the head. I used to love this helmet, but since it's white, it looks off. Actually, I haven't tested this stealth combat helmet, but the special purpose helmet, actually, yeah, same problem. I mean, it doesn't actually protect that well. The last test was a long time ago, so that most likely has changed. One of these. Back when we started KP Liberation with me the first time, we did a bit of testing with this helmet. Even the lowest powered pistol, it didn't do jack shit about it. It's worthless. But this actually works. And if I recall correctly, in the case of buckshot from shotguns, you are immune. Let's test that just for the lulz. I think the slugs also, you were immune to the slugs from shotguns. Then 14. Yes. I haven't tested the shotgun ammos, these new ones, but I have tested these cup ones. Okay, now that I got buckshots there, let's take slugs. Well, this also varies. He did take damage now, to the point that he's bleeding. There's also an angle, which I don't know if it's broken or if it's a feature, but But it simply bounces off. Of course, the further away you take the hit, the less it does. Pulse. Yeah, as you can see, he's unconscious and bleeding, but he's not dead. Yeah, as you can see. Let's try that guy from this distance. What? What? Wait a minute, did I... I think I took a single slug. Oh yeah, that's my bad. Also, these do differ. Well, he died, but yeah, this varies. Well, let's try directly to the visor. Okay, failed. Yeah. Wait, it went... Wait, what? Yeah, it missed. Okay, I have no idea if that's a bug or a feature. Never mind that noise, it was the octocamo. Oh, he died. So, well, like I said, it depends on the used ammo. They aren't created equal. The survival complete with your heart still running. It happened to me in my tests way more often than it did now. Right, it's the octocamo. I do have, let's see. Yeah. This, yeah. Let me think. Yeah, in my test, these A1 respirators has been most effective against nade form weapons like white phosphorus, gas, and that stuff. So my thinking here is that these heavy assaults, they are meant to be able to go anywhere against any infantry, against anything they can literally throw at them. And of course, no heavy troop is complete with thermal goggles. Okay, the first one should be night vision. Yeah. And white on black thermal. There is no second thermal mode. But it does have the night vision. Well, it ain't the full screen night vision, nor is the thermal. But actually, the special purpose helmet is the only one with the full screen one of both. Actually, I don't remember anymore if it had night vision, but okay, well, this wasn't intended, but whatever. Yeah, full screen night vision, black on white thermal. But at least the scope has white on black. White hot, black hot. Well, you get the idea. Of course, the problem with this kind of gear is obviously the weight. It's fucking heavy. But on the other hand, the guys aren't supposed to be running all the time. They're supposed to use the element of surprise and superior tech to kill the enemy. Oh yeah, and about these belts. These are actually not very much lighter than a full box, but they are lighter. So right, let's pick up an empty one from here. And refill. Since this is a belt, it doesn't insert in single bullets, so it's much faster. But yeah, if you cancel, you have to do it from the start. Also, it doesn't make the bullet noises, which tells it's a belt. Yeah, like that. So if I were to use, miss button. Yeah, let's insert that empty in there. So I can remove the empty. Fuck you. I don't know why that happens. I can remove the empty one from the weapon. This takes around half a minute, I think, per box. So, and of course you aren't meant to go guns blazing alone somewhere like this. So, which is why, well, for example, medics could work as the box refillers while the others are shooting. Of course, I think it takes even less time to shoot these boxes empty than it takes to refill them. But there, two filled boxes. Take the weapon. So, at first, I didn't believe Vieras 9876 when he started advocating for using belts instead of carrying entire boxes. But when I started thinking about it, especially when you are using heavier calibers like this 7.62, mostly used by the Russians and the Middle East and that kind of thing. Or if you are using the 9.2 mil calibers. Actually, I don't know if there are things like this for the 9.2, or was it 9.5, whatever, millimeter. But this saves you quite a bit of weight in the long run. So it does hold the shooting until you are refilled and reloaded, but unless you are working with one or two other guys or alone, this is mostly a very good thing. Oh yeah, and of course, rangefinder. This rangefinder doesn't use any batteries, and there are better rangefinders in terms of features, but even a long-range sniper usually doesn't need those features the vast majority of the features. Let's put that back. I'm not sure if GPS should be carried in the first place, since it's this display here, but you can use micro duck reel. Well, tell us. Wait, what? These values don't match the GPS. So I'm sure there's some kind of formula to use this wait, what? This is 6 digits. This is 5. Okay, so yeah, this ain't the same thing at all. So forget about that. Well, let's say want artillery to 043241. Okay. Set waypoint. Right. You can't see the microduckery pin on the normal map. Connect to. Was that compatible with this? No, it was the, some other thing. But generally, you don't need that connector feature. It's mostly for snipers, maybe for artillery. And I prefer that sidearm ain't carried. Instead carry more ammo for the main gun. But in some cases, sidearm is necessary. This gun, for example, I think it's from the... Wait, it says cop, so it can't be Ace X. I'll need to test this out later. There are new launchers as well. We installed a mod to bring these cameras for roleplay reasons. I've seen other Arma YouTubers use Titan or Javelin as a poor man's, or more like makeshift camera. So I think I need to tweak these heavy trooper loadouts more. But this is the general thing I've been working on. I do prefer the Octocamo suit more than the special purpose suit. Although Can I force him to take prisoner? Open inventory. Right. Still not. Okay, let's try this. Empty. Still not. Okay. Maybe with the Bergen. I haven't tested this. And if I can't force him to wear the octocamo. Yeah, I need to test that in the editor, because I don't know how this octocamo works against thermals. Since the special purpose suit, it makes you like 98% invisible to thermals under most circumstances. So it'll be essential to test how it works. Well, I guess that's all for now.